Hello everyone, this is the LEGO Star Wars Jakku Quadjumper. The following may come as quite a bit of a shock, but the first time I saw this completed in front of me, I realized that to my eyes and to my brain, it's one of the nicest looking Star Wars models LEGO has ever made. Not that it's the nicest design in universe, but as a model, it just really strikes me in a most positive way. The colors, level of detail, the shaping and the approximation of the actual shape of the thing in universe, how accurate it is, just all go together fantastically well to me. It's very pleasing to my eyes in many, many ways. It uses just a couple of large stickers on the outside that you can see down below on the lower engines to add detail, but all the rest of the detail is done legitimately with proper builds, actual building techniques. There are no techniques involved in this that are too fancy, too special, but there's some stuff that's pretty respectable and interesting in how it all goes together. Principally, there's this one out of place looking Technic ball end on the top of the thing. Now you can leave that off if you want to make it look more realistic, including the taking out the axle beneath it. But that's the trigger for the main action feature of the set. As you know in the movie, the one action this thing does is to blow up. So the major action feature of the set is to blow up. You push that down and it just pushes these out of place. Each of the upper engines is attached with a single pin and then a single axle pin. So effectively it's only really held in with the clutch power of a pin, and pushing this down just pushes apart the sides of the thing. The lower engines are attached with two pins, full pins a piece. You can pull them off manually, but there's no feature to make them come apart relatively simply. They've integrated accommodations for minifigures into this well. There's a little bit of gap along the side here, but that really doesn't bother me personally. I think the shaping of the canopy is good. You can lift that open, allows you to put a single figure in, but you can also lift the entire roof, just hinges back, to get a second figure in there as well. There are no control sticks, however, they did apply, or they have you apply a sticker to either side here. I think that's the first time that I've seen the insides of brackets used as surfaces for stickers like that, but it's a good placement, keeps everything nice and narrow. At the back, there's another flap that opens up like so, and this has a nice little feature below where you can pull out a small stud shooter to act as a tail gunning position, but you'll want that to be a manned gun as well. So all this, once again, opens up. There's a single clip there to hold on to a minifigure weapon. There's a single thermal detonator up on the wall. There's another stud where you could attach another one, and that's a seat for a minifig. So you can put a third person back here, close everything down from the top, but leave just the back flap open. And then you also have a view of the person, so they become a tail gunner with a window. I really am a big fan of the dark orange with the metallic silver. And they've also done a nice job of including the trans orange in there against the correct side of these wheels to give you just a little more good looking detail. And they've integrated in also some medium dark flesh or medium nougat as an accent color that's used in many places, which is very harmonious with the rest of the color scheme. On the underside, they have landing skids or pads, and you can turn these rear ones up. Just a single notch doesn't do much. The front one moves a bit more. Couple of ratchets up. Actually, it'll go as far as three. I think it looked best at two. This is part of the trigger mechanism here. You actually have to squeeze the base and the top to make the thing explode. So if you're just flying this around by default and you hit it from the top, nothing's going to happen. But when this is on the ground, this lower depressor plunger is always in. So you're pushing down on this, which is pushing against this, which is on the ground. That's what causes everything to come apart. If you want this to explode in mid-air, then you need to hold the lower part down and then push on this. I'm not going to do it right now because the engines will fly off and then they will break into pieces upon impact. There are also a couple of stud shooters always on the outside. You can fire those off, and they have a couple of pretend cannons that can be swiveled around. I think they're always supposed to face forward, but this is just an option that you can use. You can also change the angles of some of these aerodynamic fins around the outside just a bit, but I think they look best in their default locations. The first four figures are early movie Ray, Finn with Poe's jacket, BB-8, and Unkar's Thug. The Thug was previously a book exclusive, but it's good to have that available for more kids to be able to get in an actual set now. Nothing new to be seen here with any of these, but I think that's fine because they already did good jobs with the original representations. There's also this lone First Order Stormtrooper included, who is a heavy aura commander based on his outfit. We've gotten those pieces before, so once again, nothing new, but it's nice to get this included with the backpack unit. There's the rest of the print on the torso, and for the face,
Angry Clone!
Really strikes me as a beautiful set for something that was barely seen in the films, just a little bit in the background and then in one scene that was used in the trailer. But yeah, just a nice thing to have on display. I would love to see more creations from whoever built this, whoever designed this at LEGO. I'd love to see more of this type of earthy and metallic color scheme used for other things. Even outside of the Star Wars universe, it just works really well to my eyes, those particular LEGO colors. And I think that the overall representation of this is good for play. It's solid enough. The action features aren't overdone. The accommodation of minifigures is good, being able to get three of them into this kind of small model. Honestly, it's a little bit smaller than I expected. The minifigure selection is good, so no complaints from me. Let me know what you think though, including if you completely disagree with my opinions. Share your thoughts in a comment down below, and I'll talk to you again soon in my next video.